Hi Scorpio, welcome to my channel. This reading for today, Scorpio, this is a love message. This is a love reading for you, Scorpio. Thank you so much for being here. Thank you so much for supporting the channel. Guest viewers, if you haven't clicked the bell now and click subscribe. This is a love message. This is a love reading for you. Thank you guys for being here. Thank you for your support. If you would like to further connect with me, Scorpio, I invite you to check out the description box below. You will see all of the details about me, my channel, myself, and my team. Let's look into a love message reading for you. Let's look into your situation. And to help me out, tapping in the energy you have, Scorpio, collectively, I want you to think of your person. Visualize them. Think about them. Let us see how they feel about you, how they think about you, and what is most likely their next action or the future of the connection. If there's new love, I will let you know. If I'm going to be channeling a new love, ooh, you've got a page of wands. I will let you know, Scorpio. What is the message for Scorpio, please? What can I get for Scorpio? What is the guided message for Scorpio? The World card. Ooh, the Ten of Pentacles. This is really good. Okay, let's start your reading, Scorpio. I feel like Scorpio, I am not picking up a your reading, Scorpio. To be honest with you, Scorpio, this reading, I am not picking up anybody in the past. This is a new person, okay? I am really tapping into a very, very new vibe, okay? You get the Page of Wands. I would say there is an exciting news for you, Scorpio. Everywhere you go, I'm kind of picking up the Magician card, the Page of Wands. Everywhere you go, your vibe, your magnetism, Scorpio, the places that you would visit, the places that you would maybe working, the places or party or event, or maybe country, but places, event, party, things that you would go on a regular basis or even randomly, Scorpio, that is where you will get to connect to, I would say, a very interesting love prospect. Page of Wands. I'm also hearing the word, you will bump into love in places, events, party, even in the gasoline station. I'm picking up in the gasoline station, in the gym. You don't even have to look for it. Like, I'm kind of picking up randomly, you're sitting in a cafe or somewhere in the park. I am picking up that you're alone. Like, you're somehow alone and having your own whereabouts in here. Like, you're walking or talking or eating, but you have no idea, Scorpio, that there is, I would say, an admirer, a secret admirer looking at you. It's connected to places that you visit or you always go there because there's a familiarity in your face. I would say this is not the first time that you saw this person. Or for some of you guys, you have a crush on this person. That's why you regularly go there. So it could also be like a clinic or a spa. Because Magician card, I'm kind of picking up this Magician card. It's radar. It's your magnetism, your attraction, your vibe, Scorpio, is just so up. Look at that. It looks like an antenna. You know, you're really, really channeling love vibe in here, Scorpio. So Page of Wands, good news. Because I feel like this Eight of Wands, this Eight of Wands, I am strongly hearing the word after January 8th, which we're already past, you know. After the first week, the first Sunday of this year, 2023, after January 8th, there's a floodgate of opportunity that will open towards you, Scorpio, in love, okay? And it's really, really randomly. Like, imagine yourself, you are walking with such magnetism, attraction. Yeah. Nine of Wands, you're not looking. You're not looking. Nine of Wands. From 8 to 9, like, okay, Scorpio, you want new love? I will search for you. No, you're not looking for love in these places. Sorry, guys. I had a very good sleep and I've been astral traveling. So the places that you are going to bump into this person, it's so funny. I'm hearing the word flame. Maybe it's a grill, you know. Maybe it's food, it's grill. They have a very nice shoes, if this is a female, or a male, a shiny shoes. Very polished. There's something with the way they walk, their shoes, the way they dress up, that you would take a second look to them. Like you have this, like, this is you. This is you. You're not looking for love, but somehow you look at them. This is you. You took a second look to this person. Because there's something attractive to this person, Scorpio. It could be happening right now. Nine of Swords, the Emperor card. You have no idea, Scorpio. I'm strongly, strongly picking up that you don't have any idea that the person that you took a second look is actually the person that you're going to marry, or the person that you would end up having a long, long term relationship. So this is you, Nine of Swords. I don't think this is this Nine of Swords. This overthinking, it's not connected to love. No. I feel like this reading to me, the first set of reading, is that you have some sort of problem and it's not connected to love, you know. Like maybe you're busy, you know, Nine of Swords. Maybe you're busy. Something is going on in your life. Nothing to panic, but you're solving a problem. Nine of Swords. You're solving a problem. You're busy solving a problem. You're quite tired in terms of dealing with love, or not. I don't know. I'm kind of picking up the Nine of Swords. The Nine of Swords. The Nine of Wands. Your thoughts, like your vibe, is not looking for love because you're busy for something that you're solving. You're solving a case, you're solving a problem, you're solving a lot of to-do tasks, and Nine of Wands, you don't have an energy for love kind of vibe. Like, okay, I want to, but let me just do this. Like, there's a priority in here. You bump into love unexpectedly. You bump into someone who it's really is possibly one of the longest relationship that you would have, or the next one. So the vibe I'm getting, Scorpio, is that, okay, you're busy. I know you're busy with work, with life. Maybe you're exhausted towards the holiday season like me. But Scorpio, I want you to really don't forget about taking care of yourself. You know, things are slow, but there are problems around us. You know, I'm kind of picking up, yep, Mercury retrograde, Mars retrograde. Things are really slow. You know, I find the start off is slow, you know. But it doesn't, slow, but busy, okay? Like, you're busy and you're doing something. And in a collective reading, okay, I'm going to give you a vibe. In a collective reading, we started this year slow. Slow delay, things that we process, it's processing, but it's taking so long, Okay, that's probably why you've got the Nine of Wands, the Nine of Swords. Fine. Now, even though we're busy and things are taking, it's very slow to process it. Please don't forget to take care about yourself. Please don't forget the Empress card to look beautiful, to look handsome. And, you know, when you go out, and maybe shop, maybe jog. But if you go out of your house, I want you to have this affirmation. Go out of your house, go out and make sure that you look the Empress. That you, because the Empress is next to the High Priestess. The universe is telling you, people will look at you with two things. If they have an amazing conversation with you, and of course, if you look very presentable, polished, or beautiful, at least in their eyes, you know, because people have different preference. So you don't have to wear gowns or tuxedo, but I really want you to practice High Priestess Empress card. When you go out of the house, make a vibe, set yourself for, I want to look pretty, I want to look handsome, I really want a vibe, carry a vibe, an energy that I'm great, I'm beautiful, I'm handsome. I'm gonna step out of this house and I'm going to attract. You know, carry that mysticism, that positivity. Just make an effort not just to look good, but to feel good inside. Because you are glowing, you are radiating, like your radar, the antenna that you, it just increases your signal when you carry on that kind of vibe. Scorpio Empress card and the High Priestess, you know, you have so many beautiful qualities, and I would say physical, and the way you dress accentuated a little bit. It doesn't hurt if you put, like, to be honest with you, that's one of the greatest and best learning for 2022 for me, you know, is that if things aren't, you know, if things are not, you know, life can be sour, it can be sweet, you know, life can be busy. And one of the best experience or best learning is that whatever and however and no matter how busy life is, whatever the state of mind, the state of your life, don't forget to look beautiful, to look handsome. It's just so good, you know. So good. It just lifts you up. So, of course, and when I say this, because, come on, let's accept it, that sometimes it's the physical love first. You know, it's that physical love that connects it with the person. You know, that it's the attraction. You know, sometimes it's the instant attraction, and sometimes it's the way we look, you know. So the universe is telling you, look at that. This is the Queen of Pentacles. This is you. Looking at the pentacles, don't hurry. You know, maybe for some of you guys, okay, I'm going to go to the grocery. I'm just going to put this and that and off I go. Don't hurry. Take time to, you know, to polish yourself. You know, the Empress card, the High Priestess, the Queen of Pentacles. Take time to polish yourself, to look at yourself in the mirror, to really take time. Because if, what, like, guys, if you search for ritual and ways to connect with the love energy, it always starts by honoring your femininity, your masculinity, your beauty. You know, we are all beautiful. We all have a beautiful, you know, something is always special in us. You know, I see beauty everywhere, you know. So don't forget to spend more time to, I would say, looking more and more beautiful, looking glow up, like really boost your confidence, you know, like really claim I'm beautiful. I'm going to attract love everywhere I go. Scorpio, Queen of Pentacles, and take time. Don't, because in here, Queen of Pentacles, you're always in a hurry. You forgot to do this and that. If you look at your closet, you have so many amazing clothes or shoes or, you know, so many amazing things that you buy, you haven't used, that will assist you, accentuate your beauty, your handsome, or add on to your confidence. Where is the Scorpio swag in there? I want to see you. I want to feel you. You're so beautiful. You're so handsome. No matter how life is busy, don't forget, you know, don't forget the beauty. Don't forget, it really levels up the attraction. So take care of those vibes. Maintain those vibes, because that really will assist you. With the minute you walk into a place, I'm attracting love. I am beautiful. I am Scorpio. I am the sun, and I shine, you know. So make sure that you incorporate that vibe by saying those words, by feeling those words, Scorpio, okay? Because, yeah, if you practice that thought, that feeling, that vibe, it really increases your network, you know. We all emit energy. And if manifestation happens, it's because your energy is high frequency that it attracts right away. Love or whatever you're manifesting. Now you just give it a go. Feel that. Practice it. I want you to believe. You know, it's good to be hopeful and optimistic. So believe. Everything starts in believing. Everything starts with a thought. That thought is converted to an atom. That atom is an energy. And if your energy is going there, all of it, then you send the signal to that person or to the universe. So you're kind of wondering, why I think of this person? Because all of their thoughts goes to you. That's how strong energy. That you can really, they can channel you, and you can channel them. Good or bad thoughts, vibe, atoms, energy. You will feel it. Now, so anytime soon, Knight of Pentacles. I feel like it's, for some of you, it could be like an event in the evening. But you've got a Knight of Pentacles. Finally, this person will come into your life. The Knight of Pentacles, you know. You know, for some of you, this person, there's a book. So you will come across this person in a place. You would look at them. You would give this person a second look. But once you give this person a second look, you know, like maybe you bump into this person and you gave them a second look because they're looking at you. So you look them back. You know, it's a feeling of, you feel like, you know, in a place as, why do I feel like someone is looking at me? And when you search for that vibe, for that eyes that was looking at you, you lock in eyes with this person. Smile. Okay? Smile. Smile, Scorpio. Or they will smile back to you. Sorry, guys. I'm just putting lotion because my hands is very dry. So, smile. Once you look at them, once you lock eye, it's either they will smile at you and you will smile back, but someone will smile, Scorpio. And that's it. This is where you loop the world card. This is where this person is looped or locked into your world. If this is a male, they will follow you and they will approach you. If this is a female, you probably will go towards this person and chat. Hey, hi. So you're gonna chat with this person. So they are, it could also be an event in the evening. Smile. Look at that. And the next is history. You know, it's very magical. The Ten of Pentacles. I'm seeing you really dating this person for a very, very long time. For some of you, it could be a whirlwind romance, that your availability, their availability, it's just a perfect match. This person would even say, you know, let's not complicate things. Let's not prolong this romantic situation. They will tell you, you would even click because there's so much personality. Like, this person is very vocal. I like your personality. I like this. I like that. Let's not prolong this, Scorpio. Let's be together. You know, they're very direct. They're very open about their feelings. Not only that, but they're very, very secure and available. So this will go very fast. It will happen very quickly. You and this person will be burning the phones with text and call. And then you're going to regularly see them. And they will be wanting to regularly see you. And after 2 weeks, someone will declare love or someone will express their feelings. And let's not prolong this. You kind of also think, and they think, that it's kind of magical. Two souls bumping into that magical place. You would go back to that place. You will grow old with this person, Scorpio. Okay? So keep that vibe. You know, that vibe I describe you. Keep that vibe. Because that is your ticket to meeting this person. Scorpio. This is beautiful. Ten of Pentacles. So, thank you, Scorpio, for coming back. Thank you for being here. It's a pleasure doing the readings, you guys. I hope you've connected with me because I always connect with you. And check out the merchandise. We all have the details of the products and the service in there. Check out our Aura Ritual Candle. You just need one candle for the whole year to click and to connect with, you know. And everything is the website. It comes along with a free, like, guide on how to manifest, how to set your energy, how to ground your energy, and how to call upon the vibe in you to connect new moon and full moon. And every time you need to kind of be spiritual, to, you know, that we have a guide, we will send you that. And thank you, Scorpio. And the amazing thing about it is free shipping worldwide. It is track shipping, and of course the profit goes to my charity. So thank you, Scorpio, for your support. I will see you soon. You have a great day.